MasterCard.
With regards to working at a heart unit, we have patients that often come in and they look like they're totally fine. And sometimes we even joke like, are you a patient? And then you hear the story and, you know, they've had some symptoms or they may not have symptoms at all.
Can I get you anything right now?
No, ma'am. I think I'm good. Not unless you could magically transport my wife and kiddos up here.
I know.
I told them that y'all wouldn't throw me out on the street.
No, we won't. Sounds good. Let me know
if
you need
good camera footage.
Right.
My name is Evelyn Cadillac, and I'm an RN on Walter Tower 20, which is a cardiovascular and thoracic unit. I've been on the unit for about 2 years and with Houston Methodist for 4 years. So it's really exciting to be able to see either someone who's asymptomatic, but actually something secretly is happening, and we can solve that and make sure they have a better life in the future, or someone who's had a major event and undergoes a major surgery. It's really fascinating to see their journey out of the ICU and see how quickly they can recover from something that we know is a major surgery for someone.
Well, when it first started, it actually started several months ago. I got just kind of sick and I thought it was a stomach virus. That was just kind of my symptoms. Well, then the stomach virus didn't go away, and I started bloating and putting on weight, and like a lot of guys, it's stereotypical for us, you know, I don't like going to the doctor. My wife begged me to go to the doctor. Guys, listen to your wives, go to the doctor. Because if I'd went a lot sooner, this could have probably been a lot different story. Finally, it got to a point where it was late at night. I couldn't sleep unless I was sitting up. And I felt awful. We had to call 911. They brought me to the hospital. They got me there. I was sitting in a room. They were trying to intubate me. I was fighting. The next thing I remember was leaning over, vomiting up blood, and passing out. What I found out later, because my memory from that period of about 2 weeks after that is very fuzzy, but what I found out after that was that I actually died 3 times while they were trying to resuscitate me. They told my wife that I'd be a vegetable, that I'd never walk again. They gave her all kinds of reasons why my quality of life wouldn't be good, because they said, you know, he's died 3 times. He's not gonna still be there. But anytime they would do the tests to see if I was, you know, still had brain activity, I always passed the test with flying colors. But my wife fought for me every step of the way, love her to death. And they were able to get me transferred over here. I woke up a couple days after I got here. I was still pretty out of it. I had a lot of hallucinations from the medications, but I slowly kind of came to and regained my senses. And then, you know, here we are now, you know, almost a month later.
It sounds like your wife's definitely looking out for you, and you're committed to kind of...
She is an angel. I picked a good wife, because, you know, a lot of them out there would have listened to the experts and taken me off of life support, and she never did. She fought for me every step of the way, and I'm thankful for her, and I owe her my life.
To think that this is a man that people essentially gave up on and thought he was not going to live or walk, and to see him living and walking is pretty awesome. I think it's exciting that his wife was an advocate for him and was able to manage to get him to us where he could receive the care that he needed and to have an awesome outcome.
My recovery has been great. So when I got out of the hospital, I was still in kidney failure, extremely weak, wasn't able to move very easily. When I would take my medicines in the morning, I would be asleep for several hours after I took them. Within a month of me being discharged from the hospital, my kidneys resumed functioning and I was able to quit dialysis. That was a big blessing to me. My medicines no longer have the same effect on me as they did before. I'm able to move around and I'm much more mobile now. I still don't have quite all my physical strength back that I had before my stay in the hospital, but recovery-wise, I'd say I'm doing quite well. I was originally, they thought, a candidate for a heart transplant, but they, a couple weeks ago, they removed me from the heart transplant list and they're just going to continue seeing me in clinic. So as time went on, as I talked with people and then therapists, my mental and emotional state improved since I left the hospital. So the fact that I was able to come home a lot quicker than they expected, they were very happy with, and no one really expected. I'm very thankful to Houston Methodist for helping me achieve that goal, because I wanted to be home with my family. I didn't like being away from them. Men, you know, listen to your wives, your sisters, your moms, anyone else in your life who's concerned about you and telling you need to get checked up. I know it's not fun, but you can avoid a lot more serious problems down the road. I'd love to, as my health allows, get back into my career, whatever direction I choose to go with that. I would love to get back in the gym whenever my doctors clear me for that and start lifting weights again and get more and more of my strength back as the doctors think it's okay for me to do so. And just spending time with my kids and watching them grow up. I've got a 4-year-old and a 1-year-old, and they're my whole life right now.